Hi viewers, welcome to Learn MATLAB Simulink Basic. Today we are going to see about how to use Fuzzy Logic Toolbox in MATLAB. So for that I am going to consider a tipping problem, right? For example, you are going for a restaurant, right? You have to decide tip based upon several factors, right? So here we are going to consider two factors. So factor one is service, and then second factor is quality, and then the output will be, we are going to consider tip. Okay, so based upon service and quality, how the facility is going to be decide the tip. Okay, so how we can create this logic, tipping problem logic, by using Fuzzy Logic. Okay, so for that I am going to Fuzzy Logic Toolbox. So for that you type Fuzzy, and here you can see that this is a Fuzzy Logic designer toolbox. So here you can add a number of inputs. So here we need two inputs, one is service, another one is quality. So here I am going to add another variable, so that means input variable. So here we got two inputs, right? The first input we are going to consider as service, and second input we are going to consider as quality, and then output we are going to consider as a tip. Okay, and also we can categorize the service in terms of different factors, right? That mean we can, for example, consider you are going to categorize the service in between 0 to 1 scale, right? So it can be categorized by means of membership function. Okay, so here I'm going to create the different membership function. So here m of 1 I'm going to consider as low, and then m of 2 I'm going to consider as m, and then m of 3 known as high. That means service. So here I'm going to consider a service in three category: low, medium, high. That means service is categorized into this three region, right? Low region, medium region, high region. And same way I'm going to categorize the quality in the three region, like low, medium and high. Okay, next, based upon that we are going to provide a tip. Okay, so here also I am going to consider the tip also categorized into three category: low, medium and high. Okay, so here next step in Fuzzy Logic Toolbox design, right? Fuzzy Logic designer. So next you have to relate this input with the output, right, by using rules. So if then rules, so otherwise called fuzzy inference system. Okay, so next we are going to connect this input with the output, so by using a rule editor. So here I'm now I'm going to add some different rules for the tip, right? For example, consider the service is low, quality is low, so then I am going to provide a tip is low. So I am going to add the rule: if service is low and then quality of food is medium, so I am going to provide the tip is low, and then service is low and quality is high, and I am going to provide the tip is medium. So next I am going to consider next factor, that means service I am going to consider medium, the quality is low, and then I'm going to provide tip is low, and then service medium, quality is medium, and then I'm going to provide the tip equal to medium, and then service is medium, quality is high, and then I'm going to provide tip is medium, and then next I'm going to consider service is high, the quality is low, so I'm going to provide tip is low. Service is high and then quality is medium, so I am going to provide tip is medium, and service is high and quality is high, and then I am going to provide tip is high. So these are the rules we are created for linking that input with output. Okay, that means linking the service quality with the tip. So here we are going to create if then rule. Okay, and then after that you have to close this one. So next you can see the rules in the ruler view. So you can see the rule, whatever rule we are written here, right? So here you can see this is a rule viewer. So here you can see that service is 0.5, quality is 0.5, and tip we are is provided is 0.5. So service is, I'm going to fix it low. Okay, so tip we are giving a low, right? And then service is very high, and then quality is 0.5. So we are providing tip is 0.5. Okay, so based upon the service and quality, we are providing tip to the bearer, right? So we can relate different detail, right? That means if suppose you are going to use the fuzzy logic for your particular application, then you can relate this. That means you can first you find the inputs, what are the input you are going to provide, and then what's the output of that fuzzy logic system. So and then you can make some membership function for each inputs and outputs, and then you can connect the input and output with the fuzzy rules. Okay, so finally you can store this data, right? So I'm going to store the data, that means store this fuzzy inference system. Okay, so for that I'm going to use file, and then go to export, and then go to file. So here I'm going to store the data. File name is tip1. Okay, so once you save this one, you can see here, right? So here it will saved as a FIS file, .fis file. .fis nothing but a fuzzy inference system file. Okay, so later we can use this file in the Simulink model also. Okay, so here I'm going to use fuzzy logic controller. And then so here I'm going to provide the detail, so tip_1 FIS. okay, and then here I'm going to change to code generation. So if you are going to provide the detail directly here, means then that Simulink model as well as that FIS file should be in same folder. That means you must change this folder first. Okay, if you want to provide the detail like this, single quote tip_1.fs single quote, right? That means it going to take the detail from the your folder only. Okay, so then your simulation model and that FIS file should be in the same folder, and also you need to change the MATLAB window to that particular folder. Okay, then only it will be executed. Okay, and then it's going to receive two inputs, so I'm going to use mux. Okay, I'm going to use mux block, and then I'm going to connect two inputs like constant, right? So for providing the detail of service and quality, so one is for service, another one is for quality. And then here I'm going to use a display. Okay, for displaying the result, so what would be the tip. Okay, so here I placed the maximum value 1 1. Okay, and also here I'm going to use simulation time is INF, so because I need to change the value of service and quality, so I need to check the results. Okay, and here I'm going to save the model tip. Okay, now I'm going to simulate this one. We will check the result of tip based upon the input of service and quality values. So now you can see that when service is 1 and quality is 1, the tip here is we are providing 0.87, right? Now I'm going to change the quality equal to 0.5. So then you can see that the tip is changing, right? 0.5. So this will be changed based upon that the rules, whatever rules we are written inside that fuzzy inference system. So based upon that it will be work, right? So here I am going to make services 0, so then the tip is very low, right? And also I am going to make quality also 0, the tip is low, right? So next I am going to make 0.75. So you can see that if service is 0.75, you can see that some changes in the tip. So here I am going to change 0.75, okay? So now you can see this, there is change in tip, right? So whatever rule we are written inside the fuzzy inference system, based upon that this will be generated the output, okay? Whatever rule we are created, right? So this is a basic example for how to edit the fuzzy toolbox in the MATLAB, and then this example for a tipping problem, okay? So you can use the same kind of detail for your application also. So for that you have to fix the input and output, and then you have to create the MFC function, and then you need to relate the input and output with the fuzzy inference rules. Okay. Thank you for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.